So today we are going to discuss about the types of artificial intelligence, and this topic is very important for you. So what are the types of artificial intelligence? We divide artificial intelligence mainly two types, and based on either capabilities or based on functionality. So what I mean to say that we divide AI into two types based on capabilities and functionality. So type one and type two. Under type one, we may have narrow AI, general AI, and strong AI. Type two, we have reactive machines, limited memory, theory of mind, self-awareness. Okay? So आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस को हमने दो टाइप में डिवाइड किया है और किस बेसिस पे हमने डिवाइड किया है बेस्ड ऑन कैपेबिलिटीज एंड बेस्ड ऑन फंक्शनलिटीज एंड फ्रॉम दिस डायग्राम इटसेल्फ यू कैन फाइंड दैट एग्जैक्टली वी विल हैव व्हाट सेवरल अदर टाइप्स अंडर दिस टू मेन टाइप्स वी विल डिस्कस ईच ऑफ देम इन डिटेल्स सो टुडे वी विल मेनली टारगेट ऑन टाइप वन. Okay, type one, that is based on capabilities. So type one mein kya hai? What we are going to focus? Based on capability. And I hope you know by the term capability. Capability means what? The means aap koi bhi kaam karne ja rahe ho, kitna capable ho us kaam karne ke. Means for that work you are going to do. Up to how much or up to what extent you can perform the task is defining the capability. Okay? Kindly mute your mic. So under type one, we are going to have first subtype as weak AI or narrow AI. So type one ke andar sabse pehla jo aapka class hai or type hai, subtype hai, wo kya hai? That is your weak AI or narrow AI. Okay. So now weak AI or narrow AI. Narrow AI is a type of AI which is able to perform a dedicated task with intelligence. So many people are waiting. Wait, let me first allow them. Okay, so मैं फिर से बोल रहा हूं weak AI और narrow AI क्या है. Narrow AI is a type of AI which is able to perform a dedicated task with intelligence. Now the most common or currently available AI is the narrow AI in the world of artificial intelligence. So अभी जो हाल ही में आप लोगों ने जितना भी development देखा होगा तो actually we are talking about what? We are talking about narrow AI or weak AI. ठीक है? तो जितना भी आपने कोई movies में sci fi movies में आपने देखा होगा whatever the things that you have seen or that you are actually you have been means going through different movies or different advertisements of artificial intelligence, but they are actually restricted to up to some limit. They are being imposed some limits, and because of that, we call them only weak AI or narrow AI. Let's try to know about weak AI or narrow AI in detail. So narrow AI means what? It can perform a dedicated task with intelligence. So it can apply the intelligence only to the task for which it has been designed. Like chess playing. You know the chess, the game that has been designed only to play the chess, but with artificial intelligence. It can design, it can employ the intelligence that it had been imparted before. But if I ask that chess game to play some other games like Ludo's or any other games, then it will not be able to play that. You are agree or not? I hope you all have seen, all have gone through at least once through the same chess game राइट। सो वहां आप
yes, अगर
विद द सेज गेम आप अगर लूडो खेलने जाओगे तो ये पॉसिबल नहीं है। हाँ वहां हमने आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस यूज किया है बट ओनली फॉर अ डेडिकेटेड टास्क। नाउ नेरो एआई कैन नॉट परफॉर्म बियॉन्ड इट्स स्किल्स और लिमिटेशन, जो मैंने अभी एग्जांपल दिया दैट इज गोइंग एक्चुअली जस्टिफाइंग दिस केस एज इट इज ओनली ट्रेन फॉर वन स्पेसिफिक टास्क। सो दैट्स व्हाई इट इज नोन एज वीक एआई। असल में ये वीक नहीं है, दिस इज नॉट वीक, बट हमने जो टर्म वीक यूज किया है और नेरो यूज किया है, क्यों यूज किया है, व्हाई वी हैव यूज दिस prefix weak or narrow before AI, because they can perform the tasks with intelligence, but they can perform only the specific tasks for which it has been designed. Okay, so it cannot go beyond limits. If it goes, then it will be of course going to fail in an unpredictable way. So if we are going to cite some examples for weak AI or narrow AI, one I have already cited, and many other examples like Apple series, that is also a narrow AI. Okay, because it operates with a limited predefined range of functions. Similarly, we have IBM Watson supercomputer. Okay, then another examples like we have self-driving cars, speech recognition system. In speech recognition system, you cannot perform some other means tasks like suppose earthquake detection, you cannot perform that task, or you cannot predict earthquake with a speech recognition system. Similarly, image recognition system, these are the examples of weak AI or narrow AI. So my dear students, I hope that the term weak and narrow, or weak AI or narrow AI, is now clear to you. Although the term is weak AI or narrow AI, but do note that it is actually not weak. It has some limitations. That's why we are just fixing the term weak before it. Now, coming to the next AI, that is general AI. What is general AI? We are going to discuss now. Now, you know, general AI is a type of intelligence which could perform any intellectual task with efficiency like a human. So general AI kya hoga? Aapke jaisa, mere jaisa, agar koi robot perform karke dikha de, with emotions, then हम बोल सकते हैं कि that is general AI. तो मेरा question है कि क्या general AI available है? No, there is no such system exists. So let's discuss it again. General AI is a type of intelligence which could perform any intellectual tasks with efficiency like a human. And the idea behind the general AI is to make such a system which will be smarter and think like a human by its own. But you know, as I have already said, that there is no such system which could come under this general AI and can perform any tasks as perfect as we human does. Now, the research is of course going on in this area to build a system which will have the capability of performing the tasks in a smarter way, or as smart as we human are doing the same tasks. So the research is going on. I hope that near future we may find such a machine, but currently there is no such machine. Okay, this is again under research. So the first question of this lecture that I'm going to ask you all of you cite at least one example for weak or narrow AI. Okay, this is the first question for today's lecture. Then coming to the super AI. So super AI, general AI, आपको समझ में आ गया? सबसे पहले हमने देखा weak AI, ठीक है? Weak AI में कुछ limitation है, जो चीज के लिए हमने बनाया है system, जो चीज के लिए मतलब जो robot बनाया या जो program हमने develop किया है, that is limited to that particular task only. Then we come to the general AI, where we have seen the system can perform as smart as we human do a particular task. Then coming to the super AI. Super AI is a level of intelligence of system at which machine could surpass human intelligence. Okay? And it can perform any tasks better than us with cognitive properties. Now, my second question to you, what do you understand by cognitive properties, or what do you understand by the term cognitive? मैं आप लोगों को हिंट दे देता हूँ. जब हम कुछ चीज के लिए अपना रीजनिंग यूज करते हैं, अपना ब्रेन यूज करते हैं. ओके, सो यू नो वी हैव आवर ऑन ह्यूमन ब्रेन विथ न्यूरॉन्स. ओके, आई होप इन योर बायोलॉजी क्लास यू हैव ऑलरेडी गॉन थ्रू दिस न्यूरॉन्स एक्सन एंड डेंड्राइट, दिस थिंग्स यू नो. अल्टीमेटली वी हैव अ ब्रेन बाय व्हिच वी कैन डिसाइड समथिंग. ओके, डिसाइड समथिंग मीन्स व्हाट टू डू फॉर अ व्हाट फॉर अ पार्टिकुलर सिचुएशन. ओके, नाउ सुपर एआई मीन्स व्हाट? That level of intelligence which can suppress our human intelligence. And what actually it means to you? It means that it can perform any task better than or much efficient or better means I can say more efficient way than a human being can perform that same task. Like some key characteristics of this super AI or you can say strong AI include capability like ability to think, to reason, to solve the puzzle, to make judgment, to plan, learn or communicate by each other. So ये जो characteristics हैं, अगर ये हमने develop करा दिया कोई machine में, then that AI will be more capable of us. And that AI enabled machine can perform tasks in much efficient way than us. So that is super AI. Okay, now my question to you, whether is there any such system exists in current days era? Answer is, of course, no, because I just said that general AI is not available. General AI means the machine, the robots are as intelligent as we human beings are. Okay, that thing is not available. Then how could we think of a machine which may suppress our intelligence, which will have more power or more intelligence than us? So general AI hi abhi tak research, under research hai. Of course, super AI kya hoga? This is again a hypothetical concept. Got my point? So this is again under research. And if general AI is come into the real picture, then of course we can hope that super AI is also coming in the near future. Now, this picture, look at this picture. I'm again explaining these things. Narrow AI, dedicated for one task. General AI, perform like human. And super AI is as intelligent as human being. But you can say that not just as intelligent, but AI, super AI or strong AI are more intelligent than we human beings are. Okay, all these concepts are clear to you? About the type 1 AI. So today we have focused only on type 1 AI, and I hope that what are the topics that I have discussed, narrow AI, general AI, and strong AI is clear to you. Now, as the last question for this lecture, I want to know one particular robot where the scientists tried their best to impart emotions to a level. एंड एक्सटेंड. तो मैं आप लोगों को क्या क्वेश्चन पूछ रहा हूँ, सबसे लास्ट वाला क्वेश्चन ये है, आप मुझे वो रोबोट के बारे में बताओगे. हाल ही में न्यूज में था कि जिसमें साइंटिस्ट ने एक लेवल तक इमोशंस डालने की बहुत कोशिश की थी. ओके, सो दैट्स ऑल फॉर टुडे. आई एम नॉट एक्सटेंडिंग टुडेज क्लास बिकॉज आई हैव बीन बिजी विद दिस यू नो मेन प्रोजेक्ट presentation scheduled from 9:30 and I have already taken two lectures. So I'm not extending class for today's AI. So I hope this topic is sufficient for today.
Hello, sir.